What's up, guys? Welcome to a show where we discuss, banter, and give you maximum joy.
That's definitely right. We're here to give you 100% joy and also banter and discuss various happenings in sports. And yeah,
I'm Ali Baju Daniel.
And I'm Gabriel Ojagbase.
And today we are going to be counting down to the showdown of the KFA Community Shield and also giving you predictions for these upcoming games of this
weekend. That's right.
Don't go anywhere because we'll be right back. Welcome back, and now, Gabriel, it has been weeks, months, I might even say a year since we've gotten entertained to a game of football.
Yes.
Because I don't count my Eagles, the international games, as football.
To be very honest, this Euros was, I feel like The football was still there. I mean,
the reason why, because I don't see my collection, my favorite players playing together as well.
Right. I can understand what you're saying.
What team do you support still on your hands?
I'm an Arsenal fan. Pure, and I am proud of my team. Yeah.
I'm not saying anything.
Yeah. But is there anything to say?
Okay.
Is there anything to say?
Like, you didn't wear. You ain't supporting yours today.
I know it's not by wearing jersey that I support now. I just like color. What team are you even supporting?
I'm in Manchester United.
Yeah, Manchester United fan. What is on your logo? Is that not Nike? Let's know that if you want to go in that way, is that not Nike? What sports brand Manchester United is?
Let's not die. Premier League is starting, and tomorrow we're going to be entertained to a game of clashing,
yeah,
two great rivalries,
yeah,
the red versus the blues.
So
what do you feel, what's your opinion for this upcoming game?
What's my first of all, I don't like two teams.
I know you're supposed to have two teams.
Well done, I see what you did there. If I'm going to be very honest, it's a very straightforward game. I won't lie. It's a very straightforward game in the sense that I feel like Man City will go there and do what they are known for doing, which is
losing,
whooping you people.
Whooping us.
Whooping you people. 100%. Let's not use FA Cup to judge this.
We've played two finals. We've played two finals. In which one they won, and in which one I won.
Yeah.
Same scoreline, 2-1, 2-1. 2-1. So I believe
Guardiola is a smart man. He will use the past to flog you people.
Now let's looking at the stats. I've won the FA Cup 21 times. Master has won it. The Community Shield. I'm sorry, the Community Shield. I won it 21 times.
Because I'm very sure that it's not Manchester United that has the most FA Cups. Let me just put it out there. If you guys know, you can put it in the comments below. As we were saying,
I've won Community Shield 21 times.
Yeah.
Master has won, I think, 6 times if I'm not. And in the last 4 consecutive times, I've won it. Meaning, I go to the Community Shield to win every time.
You go to the Community Shield to win.
Last 4 times, I've won it.
Everybody goes to a particular final to win. It's not a flex.
It's a flex because the last 4 times I've played, I won.
Why?
But the last 4 times Master has played, what happened? The last they even played against you, you won them.
Yeah,
they played against Liverpool. Liverpool won them. Looking at that, you can believe that maybe Guardiola feels that it's not a major trophy, but I want to prove something to him.
Yeah, that's exactly why I feel like
it's going to
be. I feel like it's going to be something different, if you understand what I'm saying. Because most times now, when Manchester City plays this particular final now and they lose, people be like, oh, it's a Community Shield, nobody really cares about it.
He said that in the Carabao Cup when they lost, but when they were eliminated.
I know, but I'm just trying to say that people tend to be like, oh, the Community, do you feel like it's a Community Shield?
Is it a trophy that you can add to your cabinet?
Is it a major trophy? It's not, exactly.
You can't say it's a major.
My question is, if Manchester United should win
Tomorrow.
Will you? Let's and obviously go on to not win anything this season.
No.
Will you use that? Will you say that? Oh yes. At least we didn't go the season trophyless.
No.
You wouldn't.
I won't.
So if.
If I win the FA Cup, if I win the Community Shield and go on the season
without winning anything, which you're definitely going to do, but will you use that to, if someone comes and say, oh, you guys did not win anything?
I agree. I won't banter up with them. Because Man City didn't do that last season, I feel I should do that too. Just give them respect. It isn't a major trophy, it's just something you can add to your cabinet and be like, I have some.
Oh, let's not divert from the main point, which is the fact that Manchester City I feel like they will go into this particular game with a different mentality from previous. I don't know why, but I feel it's going to be they are not going to just want to play this particular community, given the fact that they've lost the last two. So
They want you, and
looking at your Manchester United team,
the present team.
Yes, the present team.
We just got two new signings.
And which one of them will be available to play tomorrow?
Joshua Zirkzee.
What happened to the other one?
He got injured.
What's his name? What's his name? I'm sorry.
His name is Lenny Yoro.
Okay.
You guys should wish him well in the comments, please. So it's just something that happened. It happened last season again
for Kobe Mayhew.
He got injured in the preseason and look at how he performed.
I'm not talking about what how he's going to perform. The availability of the players for this team. And looking at Manchester United, I don't know. I don't just feel like they would play a team like Man City and come out on top if Manchester City don't make mistakes. You know,
it's not about when Man U plays nonsense, they say it's normal. Don't say it's a mistake, but when Man City plays slide on, they say it's a mistake.
It is because it's a mistake. That's not their standard. It just goes to show the standard Manchester City have put themselves and the standard Manchester United have fallen to.
Let's come to an agreement now. What's your final scoreline for tomorrow?
Scoreline? Well, I feel the game would have 5 goals or less. So it could be a.
You mean in that game? 3-2. They are going to score 5 goals.
I'm not saying Man City.
How many goals?
Four goals. 3-1.
3-2.
Which favor? 4-0.
To which favor?
Manchester United. Manchester City, of course.
Manchester City.
Yes.
So I believe tomorrow is just going to be like. Nothing more than 3 goals.
Wow.
Either, I believe it's a 2-1 defeat.
Okay.
2-1 win.
For Manchester United.
Manchester United winning that match.
And yes, that is all. We will leave it to the players to slug it out on the pitch tomorrow. And may the best team win.
May the best team win.
I don't know why. I don't like saying it. It's paining me as I'm saying it, but I can't. Let's not lie to ourselves. May the best team win, Manchester City. And yes, after the short break, we will be giving you some predictions for today that you guys can play around and win something. Yeah, so bet wisely. And the first game on our predictions today is New York Yankees versus the Texas Rangers, and our prediction for that game is over 6.5, including extra inning. Second, we have Colorado Rockies versus Atlanta Braves, and Atlanta's total we went for over 6.5, including extra innings. And third, Arizona Diamondbacks versus Philadelphia Phillies. That game we went for over 10.5, including extra innings. And last but not the least, we have Los Angeles Dodgers versus Pittsburgh. In that game, we went for over 7.5, including extra innings. Bet responsibly and don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Also, click the notification bell to get notified when next we upload. Bye, guys.